You might say, Drenda, you know, I'm not willing to do all these things, or I don't want to do that kind of thing to get out of debt. But what would you do for freedom, for your family, to break out of the system that enslaves everyone into debt and living their life for someone else instead of living it for God and for your family? So some of these things you need to think about, really think about doing. Yep. Break the mold of what everybody else says. If you're following the crowd, you're going to be in debt like the crowd. You're going to be in the same situations, and you're going to retire broke like most of the crowd.
That's good.
We're telling you today how to do something totally different, and you can do this thing.
That's
right,
that's
Gary?
Good. Yeah, that's how it
we
is.
Would just, we want to challenge you. Be financially free.
Yep, and we're going to talk about another big area of potential money and savings, and that is private schooling, private education. A lot of Christians obviously want their kids possibly out of public school, or
sure,
they make that decision,
absolutely,
so they go to private school. But I meet, and we've done this for 30 years, help families get out of debt. I meet so many families that are spending a lot of money for private schooling, private Christian schooling, private schooling. And for instance, here's just an example of the cost. I did some research on some of the schools around. And for a kindergartner, the price was $6.52 a month at this school. And then fifth graders was $7.18 a month, 12th grader, high school level $7.50 a month. So if you have three kids, they have a few discounts, but this family would be paying $1,935 a month for three children in private school. Now, the average Christian school, the average private Christian school in America is $3,267 a year, okay? So if you had three children in typical, normal, average Christian school pricing, you're going to be paying $816 a month as a family. We had five kids, so that would be a lot higher number, obviously. But the bottom line is there an option? And we made a decision that there was an option, that I'd rather have that $816, or if it was, you know, five
$1,900
kids. $1,900. Yeah, that the hundreds of dollars a month, I wanted to use that money towards other things.
Right.
Is there a way to do it?
And I want to make sure we say this. It's not being negligent with your children's education, because what we found is that by taking that $1,900, we were able to give our children private lessons that toward their natural bent, things that they enjoyed doing.
Yeah.
So we could tailor that education and still save a lot of money. What if you took that $1,900, split it up, $1,000 of it was still being spent on your children to help tools of education and give them benefits and travel and things that you know wouldn't be able to do if they're in an educational environment where you're paying that kind of money.
Let's talk about that. So with five kids, our price would have been $1,361 for the average pricing. All right. So that's a lot of money, especially when we were just coming out of debt and that was money. And then God dealt with you about homeschooling. Now, again, some of you watching may not want to homeschool your kids, and that's fine. But I am going to at least insist you listen to the data and the numbers because it is a viable option.
And first of all, we just need to say you are called to school your children. Whether you delegate that to someone else, God will personally hold you accountable for what they learn. So don't check them at the school and think it's their job. It's not their job or the church's job. It's a parent's job. So we take that as a calling of God. Now, are you going to delegate it to someone and pay on top of that? And are the results going to be what you want?
Right. And so we homeschooled all of our five kids. And so we saved over those 12 years. We homeschooled them all the way up to college. So that's $196,000 we saved without adding any interest benefit to that, you know, if I had invested the money.
Right.
That's just a pure, basically $200,000 savings.
Yes.
So we're finding money everywhere.
Right.
But
and
let's talk about that.
There was not any negligence on their school, their education, with that $200,000 in savings. We took them on trips to Europe, to Alaska. They actually saw and learned from textbooks and seeing the actual thing.
And
so you're not talking about, let's just be cheap on our kids' education. No.
No.
Let's give them a better education.
Let's look at the
and
data also. Homes, now, again, I'm talking, I am for homeschooling, so you know that. Homeschoolers nationally perform one grade level higher than private school students, four grade levels higher than public school students by current surveys. And in our experience, our kids did exceptional. They all went to college. They all have a bachelor's degree. They all got 4-point grade averages in college. We had several of our kids go to school at age 16. In fact, our youngest daughter actually graduated from college with a bachelor's at age 16, just as she was about to turn 17. That is incredible.
And this isn't hard. It's not a difficult thing. We're talking an hour and a half to 2 hours of your day to school your kids. Most of you are spending that much time on homework anyway, because what happens in the classroom is most of it is discipline and shifting and herding kids here to there to different places, dealing with discipline problems, moving the class at the pace of the lowest learning level, so your child can actually advance and move faster through the work. But if there's an area they're not getting, you can take time and go over that area so they get it before you move on. So all the way around, you're able to tailor it to your child in an hour and a half to 2 hours a day. And I'm telling you, we skipped some days too. Took some field trips and that kind of thing.
And there's a lot of curriculum online and different ways to train your child. Right. So just consider that.
Can I add also, all five of the children are serving the Lord.
Yeah.
So that's another huge benefit. None of our children rebelled against God or us.
Yes. Okay. Hate to move us. I know this is a big topic we want to talk about, but let's talk about college. Now, I've been in financial planning and financial areas for 30 years, and I have seen horror stories, folks. Let me just tell you, this student loan thing, I mean, I've seen so many people come out of college that owe hundreds of thousands of dollars. I just talked to a woman who owed over $400,000 in student loans, and her dad co-signed for it. She's now working at a job that pays, $30,000, $40,000 a year. And this is a sad story, but Drenda, I see that these student loans shackle these young people with thousands and thousands of dollars worth of debt. They're paying over $100,000 a year, over $50,000 a year for college. And I'm telling you, it doesn't have to be that way.
Right, and the income can't even keep up for the rest of their life. They can't get back the money that went into the education.
So, just a couple tips. Make sure your child knows what they want to do before you spend the money.
Right.
Go to a community college to get some of the prerequisites out of the way. Don't send them away to school and spending big bucks.
Let them try. Let them apprentice with someone. See if it's something they enjoy doing.
Right. If they want to be a nurse, send them down to the hospital and let them shadow a nurse, but let them try things out. Think of how much that money would have done if they would have started a business. In other words, that's a lot of money. Make sure it's going to do what you want it to do when it comes time for their life. We've got to wind up, Drenda, we're out of time, but another area we want to touch on is just home life in general. And you can find money all kinds of places, but we'll be back in just a minute talking more about family life with a family that wants to get ahead, stay out of debt, serve God. Hi, I'm Gary Keesee, and you will never fulfill your destiny until you fix your money thing. Visit GaryKeesee.com and don't forget to hit the subscribe button below for more amazing weekly videos on fixing your money thing, and thanks for watching.